just like,
you might as well be real about it. Ruby, come here.
Look at that little breakfast. It almost looks like a bodybuilder breakfast. Kind of, barely, just barely.
All right, ladies and gentlemen. Sorry that I look super musty right now. I was sick. I got like this weird stomach virus. I think I ate something or bad meat, or I don't think I was actually sick. I think I ate something bad. And dude, I was in bed for like 3.5-4 days, just not eating, in and out of the bathroom, you feel me? Like, I probably slept like 50-60% of the day, and then I wasn't working out, obviously. So I had to take like 4 days off of the gym, and this was right after that last aggressive leg day that I posted. And it sucked. It kind of pissed me off because, like, I don't really get sick too often. And then randomly, this last winter and then just leading into this year, dude, I've been sick like 3 times. It is what it is. It sucks. And this one was just annoying because I was a month in my cut. Things were going pretty solid. I was training super hard. And then I just get bedridden for four days. Like, 4 days I didn't go to the gym, but I feel like you guys understand, like, you know, when you take like 4 days off from the gym, your fifth day back, your first workout's generally, it's not gonna be as good as when you were in a groove or whatever. When I'm at the gym, I also have my carbs. This is actually like post-workout carbs from Gorilla. They just restocked this recently, but I don't know if it's still in stock, and they don't restock it a lot. But I use it as my intra-carbs. It's like 50 grams of carbs in total for one serving, and I drink that alongside with my whey protein. So that's the lineup for the gym. We're linking up with the homies today. It's not just me and Pete. Ballo is gonna make an appearance, and we're gonna crush a chest day. We're in the second month of the program, Jared's programming, and you guys have been watching along, you kinda know how it goes. So we're kinda resetting, we're changing the exercises that we've been doing just a little bit, and we're kinda resetting on the sets too. So when I go in today, I'm only hitting a small amount of sets compared to what it's gonna look like at the end of the month. Like you guys know, we add just a little bit each week, hit that deload week at the end of the month, and then change the programming and restart with a smaller amount of sets and work our way up, you know, progressively overloading and whatnot. And the RPE, or what we're going to, is supposed to be, we're back to 3 from failure. So the intensity's turned down just a little bit. Just because we're simply not doing as much volume, but I'm still gonna go balls to the wall today. I wanna really take it to 3 from failure, so I'm gonna push myself a little bit. All right, but I think that's it before we go hit this lift. I feel like a bunch of you guys are gonna ask about the sweatshirt because this thing's dirty. Definitely my style. This is from Headcase. Headcase is a really small clothing brand that just started. I know the owner personally. He's a friend of mine, so I like wearing his stuff to support him. And I just really fuck with their clothing, honestly. Like, this shit's dope. I like the vibe. So be sure to show them some love if you like this kind of style of clothing. Dallas just found this little mailbox postal service truck, like in my truck, like over there in the compartment. I have no idea how this got here. If Kat didn't put this here, I have no idea. Oh, shit! In the jungle, the gorillas be violent. Deep in the gang, my domain. Small time banging, that's what that is. If you ain't scheming, you were making drug deals.
Howdy.
Howdy, partners.
With the cornrows, shit.
Just got out of prison the other day.
Don't do it to
just
him.
Did 30 in the pen.
You were cellmates with Booby, weren't you?
Yeah.
All right, so we're about to get into it. We're back on incline Smith machine presses, but we're going a little bit heavier today, just a little bit. And we're only doing 2 sets, 3 from failure. After that, we're gonna move over to machine flies for a few sets, and then we're gonna go back to another pressing movement, and then if I'm not mistaken, we have a couple of arm exercises we're gonna do at the end, so should get a pretty cool pump, but it's gonna be a nice moderate pace workout, I think, because there's 3 of us, so should be good.
In my room, 4 black walls, tie the noose, no recall, no resolve, fuck withdraw, rather shoot up till I fall. Murder on call with the fight now, 20 years and it seems like a lifetime. I've been hanging every day from a lifeline, bodies fucking sailor dinner every nighttime. Smoke in that dope off the floor, let me blow. Hopefully don't come, don't fuck with y'all. Sprite paint the walls with blood and whatever. Drag you outside, let you rot in the wet. I don't think I can explain any better. I'm scared from the terror and live for the less. My birth was a never.
Don't relax and let it drop. Control it all the way down and feel it like top your chest. So don't like, you don't want to go with all that control and then the last 3 inches you kind of drop it to bounce.
Yeah.
Because then you're losing that last portion of stretch out of the pec. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Not bad. Just.
What are you saying?
So on the bottom half of these, when you get down to here, not dropping to let it kind of pop a little, controlling it to the point where like it literally just taps your chest.
Okay.
That amount of control.
I used to bounce off the chest too, but then you come to the realization that what's the point? If you're trying to work the muscle, that isn't working the muscle. Going slow and controlling the weight and getting a good press, that's what's actually gonna work the muscle. So that's just counterproductive. Oof. It's funny. It's always funny trying to judge 3 from failure.
Hell yeah. Way to work, bro. Go, go, go.
Fuck yeah, bro. Jared has me in love with the Smith machine press. The incline, I slept on it. That shit's nice. If you have a good Smith machine, I almost like it better than freeway incline. It's sick.
15 to 20 probably.
Look what the cat dragged in.
Takeover.
You guys both wore pink intentionally?
Oh no,
this I is Haley, the homie.
What this up? Is my best friend ever.
I miss you. Come here. Do you miss me?
Ruby's really the best dog ever,
aren't you?
I'm sure everyone says that about their dog.
Yeah.
What do we get?
That's a surprise every time.
Mukbang with Dallas. You guys getting grimy on some yeah. T-Bell.
The new one. Oh, it is.
Try it.
No, that's the beefy five layer.
Smack it. You know the beefy five layer is going to hit, bro. Dallas is going to start doing mukbangs on the channel. Is it fire?
Beefy five layer.
But that's gonna actually do it for the video today, I think. A lot of shit's going down though. A lot of shit. At the end of the month, just be ready for a tearjerker. That's all I'm gonna say. I don't wanna get too into it, but hold your breath. Alright, that's it for this video though. P-Way the only way.